It is quarterly results time for Volition RX. We normally start with the Group Chief Executive, Cameron Reynolds, but Cameron's stood on the sidelines at the moment, giving way to Dr. Tom Butera, who is Chief Executive of Volition Veterinary. And Tom, welcome. The very fact that you're going first suggests that it has been an extremely busy quarter for the veterinary team.
Well, thanks, Nick, and thanks everyone for joining our call today. Been extremely busy, Nick. We've been, to use a football analogy, we're on the 10-yard line, first and goal, and looking to hopefully score a touchdown here in 2021. We have been interacting with three of the four top global veterinary companies in the world. We've had a wide range of negotiations going on with all of them. We've been talking to them about reference lab, about point of care, about exclusive versus non-exclusive agreements. And it's obviously been a very involved period of time and required a tremendous amount of attention on our part. And also, because our test is the first cancer screening test to come to the market, this is a launch that these multinationals are taking their time to make sure that it's right, making sure that they are comfortable with it, and they have no reference before. So we understand that due diligence.
As we said at the beginning, interesting times, Tom. I just wanted to clarify, you are talking about American football with that 10-yard line. And what I want to know is, as far as due diligence is concerned, is the gain line in sight?
It very much is. We're very close, Nick. They've been evaluating four particular areas and with reference to IP, intellectual property, validation of the test, in their hands as well as in ours, understanding everything about the beta launch itself in terms of all the information we've received from veterinarians about how to utilize the test. They are making sure that they can communicate that appropriately to their veterinary teams and to the people that they are interacting with on a worldwide basis. And they have also spent a lot of time trying to understand the total adjustable market. It is immense. There has not been a screening test out there yet. So they're really trying to identify that, making sure it's consistent, and also our platform development. So those four areas is where they've been spending their time. And obviously the due diligence period has been extensive.
So what would you say has been the most important thing you've learned from the beta launch, Tom?
Well, the first one is about pricing, Nick, quite frankly. We've really been looking at really trying to position this first new QVET cancer screening test under a sub $75 price point to the end user, meaning the pet owner, potentially even as low as $50, because we don't want pricing to be an obstacle and we want some general worldwide application and adoption of this test. That is something that's been very well received by our veterinarians. I've spoken to hundreds of veterinarians about this, and they very much are looking for that low cost aspect to this test. The other part about it is it has a tremendous mass market. There's nothing else out there like it. So consequently, the veterinary community does not have this tool in their toolbox.
Yes, and of course, one of the spin-offs from this dreadful pandemic has been the worldwide explosion of pet, and particularly dog ownership. So obviously opportunities there. Would you say a deal is getting quite close now?
The deals should be very close, Nick, and it could be several deals. And the anticipation is our primary laser focus right now is to get one, two, or three of these deals worked out. And the hope is that we will have an initial signed term sheet by the end of 2021.
And of course, that's not all the veterinary team have been up to. I also noticed recently that you'd produced some new data, and that had been presented to the VCS, for the uninitiated, the Veterinary Cancer Society Annual General Meeting. What did that say?
The Veterinary Cancer Society meeting is highly attended by many of the veterinary oncologists across the world. So obviously there's some very important information they listen to. And at that meeting, Dr. Heather Wilson-Robles, who is our Chief Medical Officer at Volition Veterinary, presented information about our hopeful second Nu.Q product, which we're anticipating rolling out in 2022. And this is a product that is going to be involved with the monitoring of disease itself, as well as remission. When we have animals that are utilized or diagnosed early on with our screening test with Nu.Q, and then you have these animals are now being put into a treatment situation, there is not a tool other than imaging and a lot of blood work that can monitor whether the treatment has been successful. This potential tool will give them a low-cost, immediate answer as to whether where that disease is going, and is the efficacy of what they're using for the treatment working. In addition to that, when we are able to get them into disease remission, the ability to be able to utilize this test again, this monitoring tool, when these animals are in remission, we'll be able to identify, hopefully, maybe even to a couple of months prior to them coming out of remission, being able to be on top of that in terms of that animal's progression.
And will this be a second product to monitor?
This will be. This will be a second product that will come out. It will have a specific use for both disease use as well as remission.
Well, that's all great news, Tom. And we're going to get reaction now from Cameron Reynolds, Group CEO of Volition, who's been stood patiently on the touchline. Cameron, you must be absolutely delighted and proud of the way the veterinary team have been performing.
Yes, indeed, Nick. They've done an amazing job, not only coordinating three very complicated negotiations with three of the four biggest vet companies in the world and launching our products worldwide, which has been a huge due diligence process. And not only that, but they've kept it all going in the laboratory, also with the second product right behind. So that's been extremely exciting.
Well, moving from one pillar of the group to another very important pillar, Cameron, New Q Nets. What's the update there?
Yes, Nick, as we've talked about a lot, it's an incredibly exciting area. Ptosis is something that kills people, a very wide range of people and a very large number of people, in conditions as separate as COVID, influenza, cancer, and of course sepsis. So it's a huge killer. And if you add all that up, it's the biggest killer in hospitals for sure. And our platform, I think, can help in a very large number of ways. So I couldn't be happier. Now that we've had all these great results, we're working through shifting gears into the product side. So we hired a specialist, Remy Rabouf, who's an expert in these kind of kits and how to launch products in Europe. And he's been doing a lot of work on our strategy for launching not only in Europe, but also with working with a team in the US.
Well, that's all good news, Cameron. Regulation and regulatory authorities around the globe, extremely important. How would you describe your regulatory strategy?
So Remy and the team have put together a strategy for Europe, and I'll go through the US in a second. And as we know from before, Europe, the CE mark can be easier to retain, and it's a huge market. So the strategy, they've decided to go for a very broad and therefore large claim of like a CRP-like claim. CRP is C-reactive protein, which is one of the biggest blood tests in the world, and it's a general measure for inflammation. And the target broad claim our team are going for is for the detection and evaluation of infection, tissue injury, inflammatory disorders, and diseases associated with ptosis, which is a massive claim. And something which would be CRP, for example, as an inflammation marker, is about 85 million tests per year worldwide. So I think our fantastic results we've got, the huge market in ptosis, and a very low cost, easy to use platform. This is exactly the same platform as everything else. Off the back of that, to do a 510K study in the US, which we'll be announcing the details of as soon as we have it, and looking to start right after we've got the CE mark over the summer in a broad range of platforms.
And of course, cancer research is still such an important field globally. How would you describe the latest state of play on Volition's cancer research?
There's a few things. Obviously, it's been affected by the pandemic, and that's why we pivoted in short term to ptosis and to the vet side, because that's something we could do during the pandemic. You'd have to say that the most productive during the pandemic in collection has been in Asia. So we're very excited to say both the lung and the colorectal trials have made progressed very well. And the preliminary analysis has been done on the colorectal side in Taiwan and is going to be presented early next year at a conference. So that's something to look forward to quite soon. And we're working in Taiwan on the same thing on the lung side, and we expect also to be able to publish that as well. So very good progress in Asia. And we're also working with a large company in China, which we've talked about adapting our platform there. So we'd expect to have some news on that. The US has been a little more problematic because of the lockdowns and the collection processes have been a bit more difficult. So that's been a process where EDRM has been slow but steady. And at least for the moment, they're sticking with their target of the end of next year to finish collection. So hopefully that's something they can stick to. And the two blood studies we've had been going, the monitoring study, we've had some encouraging results, but we're not going to be publishing that in the short term because we had some missing samples. It's been good results, so we're continuing collection, but we expect to continue collecting and have that released when we can sometime next year. And the large study, the 1000 NHL, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma study, we've used the time to change the platform from the plates, which is what we've been doing up till now, to a much more high throughput platform, and which can be done much quicker and much easier by the clinicians. And therefore, we expect to start collection for that in Q1 and have it finished sometime in 2023.
And I think I'm right in thinking this study will have an impact on recruitment. But looking at the US and some of the delays that have occurred there, I gather this is leading to a bit of an organizational shift within Volition.
We've decided and really realized that we need to upgrade the manpower, the person power in the US, and really, really have a sharp focus on production and regulatory side. So I'd like to announce today, we've also moved, our best operator in the company, Dr. Michelle Gattan, to the US a couple of months ago. For those of you who know the company, he's put the team in Europe from 10 until about 50 people, and he's also commissioned the two large facilities, our original 20,000 square foot research and the 10,000 square foot production. He's a brilliant operator, and we put him to task to really broaden the US team to more than just a small number of people, both on the production side by outsourcing, also to make sure we have the regulatory team, as I discussed, and also really helping on the new Q capture side, where we've made some really good progress. So I think you'll have a lot more personnel in the US and really good specific people to make sure we can keep aggressive timelines and have the horsepower, if you will, to really make sure big things happen in the US on the regulatory side and the production side. So keep an eye out for that.
Well, thanks, Cameron. Always good to talk to you about Volition. And also waiting patiently is Terig Hughes, the Chief Financial Officer, because it is important, Terig, that you give us the financial highlights during a bulletin about the quarterly results. So what are those highlights?
Well, thank you, Nick. I'm pleased to say that we remain in a healthy financial position. We have a strong balance sheet and cash position with cash and cash equivalents of $22.9 million as at the end of the quarter. And that compares with $19.4 million at the end of last year. The net loss for the quarter was $7.2 million compared with $5.6 million in the previous quarter. The increase was mainly due to non-cash items. By contrast, our cash burn averaged $1.7 million a month over the quarter, and that was lower than the prior quarter. And that mainly reflected our ongoing efforts in cash management and cost control.
Okay, so positive news there. What about revenue this quarter?
From a revenue perspective, sales of our Nu.Q Vet screening product from our beta launch were stable with last quarter, and that's as expected given the nature of the beta launch.
So finally, in conclusion, obviously finances are always a serious business, but you've got a bit of a smile on your face when you're talking about Volition's financials at the moment.
So as Cameron mentioned, we are expanding the team, particularly in the US. And with that, we do expect that our costs and our cash burn will creep up slightly. And so by the end of the year, we do expect cash burn to be in the region of about $2 million a month. That said, we have a strong balance sheet and we are in a very good position to deliver on our commercial milestones.
Okay, Terig Hughes, Chief Financial Officer. Thanks very much for filling us in. Thanks also to Cameron Reynolds, Group CEO, and also Dr. Tom Butera, who is Chief Executive of Volition Veterinary. Lots been happening. You can find out more detail if you want it, of course, on the Volition website. But for the time being, from Nick Wood on the quarterly results for Volition RX, bye for now.